Good afternoon, Rich Tyson here. Hey, there's good news in the world of employee engagement. Recently, I opened my email to see a headline from the Gallup organization proclaiming that employee engagement is at an all-time high. In 2019, Gallup found that the percentage of highly involved, enthusiastic, and committed workers reached 35%. Now, you may immediately recognize that that leaves 65% who are not similarly engaged. So, why are many of us celebrating? Well, in the year 2000, only 26% of employees surveyed were highly engaged, while 18% were actively disengaged. In 2019, only 13% were in this disengaged category. The 9% increase in engagement, coupled with the 5% decrease in active disengagement, represents an addition of approximately 12 million new highly engaged workers and 7 million fewer who are actively disengaged over the past two decades. The economic impact of this trend is enormous. In their 2006 book, 12, The Elements of Great Managing, authors Rod Wagner and James K. Harder noted that conservatively lost productivity due to disengagement is over $300 billion per year in the United States. A 9% improvement then is somewhere around $30 billion each year. Indeed, there is much to celebrate. And that said, there is still much room for improvement. A full 52% of workers, while not actively disengaged, are what Gallup calls psychologically unattached to their work, who put time but not energy or passion into that work. And of course, there is that other 13% who simply bring nothing to their jobs but discontent and distraction. So, two questions loom heavily here. What has changed over the past two decades to bring about the improvement in employee engagement? And second, what can be done to continue and expand that positive trend? The answers to these questions reside within the companies that have implemented specific changes over the last 20 years. These changes tend to fall into four categories. First, an intensified focus on the vision of the CEO, founder, or business owner. Gallup notes that these companies have a well-defined purpose and brand. Their why is clear, as is their mission and the values that govern their behaviors, practices, and policies. This clarity is often not perceived by the casual observer, but it is abundantly understood by fully engaged employees. Author Kindra Hall, in her book Stories That Stick, shares the story of one of her clients, a trucking company, whose apparent purpose was to move things from here to there. Their people, however, understood their work as helping customers keep their promises. Kindra defines this as a noble purpose. Their employees understand how their engagement is essential to the achievement of that purpose. Engagement is highly relevant to their everyday work rather than an abstract concept. The second category here of change, managers become coaches rather than bosses. They have moved away from command and control management to encouraging their teams to solve problems on their own. Our colleague, S. Brett Savage, defines these managers as phase three leaders, those who have moved beyond having all the answers to become facilitators of collaborative ideas and solutions. The third major category of change, much less secrecy regarding the strategic thinking at the top and much more general communication and collaboration. Best practices are regularly disseminated and discussed. Employee questions and suggestions are entertained. CEOs and managers make room in their busy schedules to regularly meet and pay attention to their people. They strive to ask good questions, and then they listen. This is ideally a combination of both informal and institutionalized calendared meetings. The general rules are nothing is out of bounds, and if we don't have an answer, we'll find out. Such ambiguity and vulnerability can be a bit unsettling, but it generally has a highly positive effect on employees. When they know no topic is off limits, trust, support, and engagement almost always increase. The fourth major category of change, higher expectations for accountability, along with recognition of those who are highly engaged at all levels of the organization. Employees who clearly fulfill their roles in bringing about the achievement of the company vision are recognized and rewarded. On the other hand, mediocrity is not tolerated. Each employee is expected to make strong individual contributions and their managers are expected to sustain, support, and facilitate those contributions. These four strategies have been instrumental in bringing about substantial improvement in meeting the challenges of employee engagement for business leaders who have been willing to become more deeply purpose-driven, to let go of command and control management, to communicate more broadly and deeply, and to expect, recognize, and reward those team members who are highly engaged. Hey, I hope this has been helpful to you today. Certainly consider these things as you look at making your own teams more engaged in their work. And thank you for listening.